Welcome to the final stage. Are you ready?
Yeah, boy.
Good. I noticed you didn't upload a certain video. We'll go over that now.
Man, honestly, I don't even feel that bad about that. I have almost no doubt I'm gonna be able to hit this. I'm recording this before I do it, because I know exactly what I need to change. No big deal.
Pretty embarrassing, wasn't it?
I mean, it looked like I had a good mentality about it. Obviously, missing 120 pounds below my max isn't exactly fun, but I think
submit a yes or no answer.
Yes.
Well, this is very simple. You submit the amount of time you're willing to train with no PR, and I will scale the odds to that timetable. The odds that you will hit a new PR again. Okay.
Oh, one thing. Can I ask, what's the 0.03% chance for?
Cancer.
Oh. Well, yeah, I guess that's always possible. You don't know anything specific, right?
Good luck.
Growing up and hit this magic. With the gang, we ball out, it can't get tragic. All we got, we gon' let you niggas have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change my habits.
All we got, we gon' let you niggas have it. Stuck in my ways, think I need to change.
Pick your weight.
Well, I probably should retake that, but I want a shot at 1600. Fuck it.
Scene, they like lights, camera, action. You can see it in my eyes, all I do is hustle. They try to knock me off my feet, I'm ready to rumble. Feel like I ain't ate in weeks, working off the muscle. Oh yeah, oh my, we ride. For my brothers, no lie, all you niggas can die. Never wrong, they right, I ain't changing my side. Yeah, we in it for life, if you down, we ride. Look in the mirror, now I'm feeling like a savage. Tell my son I love him, for him I'ma make it happen. Now my dream's reality, not going back to trapping. You say that you proud of me, I turn my back, you laugh. Hey.
Okay, so you just saw my first PR total since 2015. In 4 years. It's been a long time, and it's actually pretty strange to change my perspective and my mind frame on this, because I'm so used to thinking, okay, just one up the last one. When I'm squatting 562, all I'm thinking about is when I squat 550. When I squat 550, all I was thinking about was 525. I wasn't thinking my lifetime best is 573. So the squat's the one lift that I haven't upped yet, but I think 573 at least was there on that day. You know, I have zero back pain now. Totally good, and that is something that I mean, honestly, still think about it literally every day. Every day when I wake up, what will happen is when I warm up on the squat, usually a hip will pop a little bit with like 225. Every single time I think, did I hurt myself? And I have to remind myself, I think this every workout, and the answer is always no, but I still think it. It is pretty strange though to think the total is 55 pounds above what I've ever done. And it's kind of funny too, because I've never really been able to put all three lifts together. And right now, it's not like any one lift is just exploding to a level that I didn't think I could do. It just goes to show that if you put it together on the platform on the same day, your total can be so much higher than if you hit one-off PRs sprinkled throughout the years and in, you know, varying conditions, of course. So I just feel way more confident in my ability to predictably get a training effect, and in all the small details. I would say it's not even about knowledge anymore for myself. It's about wisdom. It's about knowing, like, okay, you can reason an argument for why your last heavy day should be 8 days out or 7 days out even versus 5 days out. For myself, I find 5 days out works significantly better than seven. And I think you see that from a lot of coaches at the higher level, is that those little things that sound like almost bro science, when it comes to the individual response, those things are the difference maker. You know, everybody's doing the squat bench deadlift. I think now everyone's doing singles year round, but that makes a gigantic difference. So it's not like singles year round is something that conceptually didn't make sense. It's just, no, actually do it and do it all the time and never stop doing it. And you might make progress that you would never believe. That's at least from my experience. Someone who has kind of an aversion to singles and is more, I love doing pause squats for sets of 8 and 5 and stuff like that. So really, I've just been able to put string together these preps where there's no mistakes. There's no mental mistakes. I didn't do a single thing that I thought I shouldn't do this prep. Literally not one. And it's actually kind of weird to say that, because even when I was talking to some people, is a lot of times people go, well, yeah, you know, occasionally you just kind of YOLO it. And I'm like, I don't ever. I really don't ever. I never, this whole time, I've never attempted 700 on delt bar, never attempted a squat that I've missed that I haven't shown, nothing. And I mean, when you really do make no mistakes, it's unbelievable how much it pays off on the platform. But now moving forward, what I'm going to do is have two goals. So I have a 487 Wilks now. My goal will be a 500 Wilks, probably at Nationals, maybe even after Nationals, but that's just something that's on my mind that's lurking, because a 500 Wilks was my lifetime goal. And that would require around a 1640 to 1650 total. And it depends on my body weight. However, the goal more immediately is to make prime time. So for those who are unaware of prime time, it's basically for Raw Nationals, they have a very low qualifying total, probably to make more money, certainly to make more money. You know, they make well over $100,000 off of one meet. So what they do basically is they make it more elite for just 10 lifters to go later in the day. So that's the group that I want to see if I could get into. And if I did, I think the achievement of making prime time, even more so than my results at the meet, would be the most important thing to me personally. Because to be honest, I'm not remotely close to top 5 or top 3 at Nationals at this stage in the game. However, if I made prime time, it would just be a really cool accomplishment. And I'm just going to be completely strategic with this. I have the list of people above me. I also look at historical precedents. I coached the guy who was the last to make it before. He was ranked 17th. I want to be in the big show and do everything I can to get in it. Because I also said at the start of the year that I think it would take around 1615 plus, and I told 1609. So how stupid would I feel if I told 1609, what if it does take 1615 plus, like right around that, and then I just didn't sneak in? Some people say, hey, maybe it'll take 1660 or 1650. Well, if it does, okay, let's just see it happen. Last year it took 1597. Let's see how much extreme, or how much more extreme it gets. I want to see it for myself. One, go. Come on, stay with me. Prime time, prime time.
Ha! Go. Come on.
Prime time. Hey, Johnny, you want to call it a day?
Come up, got them all oozing. Took a long way to take it out of Houston. Took the metro and we were still booming.
Seven weeks to raise your standing. Next meet prep begins. Now.
You're my truth, you're my questions, you're my food, you're my stress, and you're my mama too. I'ma say my- patterns, some of which are genetically determined, some of which are built up by experience. We'll see if you can relax as much of this machinery as you can. That which is aware of restlessness is not, in fact, restless. There really is no outside and inside.
This is the live Raw Nationals roster, and this is absolutely insane. Now, you see my name here. I submitted with one day to go with a 740 kg total. I was ranked exactly 10th. So that was mind-blowing. That was perfect. And I grinded up my last deadlift, remember, at that meet. And that caused me to be 10th because otherwise I would have been 13th with my total in Texas. So had I not done the meet last second to where you have to submit a late fee, had I not hit every single attempt grinding, had I missed any one of those grinders, I would have been out. But after all of that, there was still one day to go. So I was extremely happy, but also, you know, a little bit anxious, like, oh, maybe someone's gonna submit. Look at this. Charles Otta, 83, 750 kg. So 10 beyond mine, making me 11th. In the cuff the past 2 years, I calculate, they don't say it, or I just tracked it, not a calculation. It was 10. There's 10 people each time, there's 8 people in other weight classes, but 10 for 83 kg the past 2 years. So I'm out. But I'm not. Because look at this. This is insane. Is after all of that, so barely grinding, put myself in position, competing last second, after all of that, if you go to Charles Otta, let me go to his profile. 83.37 body weight. And the meet before that, 727. So that is just insane. I might make it by 0.37, by grinding, by late meet entry, every single thing possible. I put it together, just give myself a shot. And that was the goal. They're like, hey, it might be unlikely. Let's see it. Let's put up a better total than it took last year, same rank that it took last year. And then let's just see what happens.
In my mansion, also fucking teed. I'm in my living room dancing. HD in my pocket and got the tech in my hand. Walk around like that nigga, so they hate when I stand. Smoke my joke, get face in my mansion. Also fucking teed. I'm in my living room dancing.
No, I could not give up.
No.